17 years ago, I was on this street corner here in New York, Brooklyn, that is. That's my home. That's where I live, okay? That's what I tell you. I was here, and it was night, and I decided that I was going to pull down my pants on this street corner right here and take a squat, because I had to take what we call in the industry a dump. Now, so I'm sitting there, squatting, that is, squatting. I'm squatting, and I look up. Do you want to know what I see? I see a raccoon, okay? A raccoon making out with a cat. Okay, this is in New York City, okay? Brooklyn. There is a raccoon making out with a cat. The interesting thing of the story, now, let me tell you. The interesting thing of the story is as I'm squatting there on that street corner, looking into the eyes of a raccoon as he makes out with a cat. Now, the interesting thing to this story is that at this point in time, I have what I call epiphany, okay? I have a thought in my head. The thought is, it's a revelation, okay? And I'm going to share it with you now. The revelation is that at that moment, while I'm bent over, my knees bent on that street corner, squeezing out what I consider a perfect toilet, I realize as I'm looking at this raccoon's eyes as he makes out with a cat, I realize that, listen to this, this is the interesting part. Time travel is possible, because that night as I'm squatting on that street corner 17 years ago, watching a raccoon make out with a cat, I realized to myself, and I'm telling you now, that time travel is possible. Would you believe me if I told you that that night, I, sir, made a toad travel back in time? Now, I'm not positive that I made this toad travel back in time. What I am positive about is that as I'm sitting there squeezing out this toad, and I'm done, the toad is not there. Now, that is time travel in my mind, because I know it was there, and then it's not on the street beneath me. Now, I know there could be some explanations, such as the raccoon was in cahoots with the cat, and had a raccoon friend come up and steal the toad, either from my butt or from the ground. But I'm telling you, there was no markings on that ground. So that raccoon would have had to get inside my butthole to take that. And I believe they are very good bandits. That is why, sir, besides time travel and this and that, and my squatting 17 years ago, that is why, my friend, the raccoons are known in Brooklyn, New York as, to me at least, butt bandits. That's it, my friend. That's it.